Welcome to week 2 of Hammer Homage, where I'm looking through Hammer's history through some of the films they released. Today I am looking at a film that shows the struggle between man and the beast within. This is The Curse of the Werewolf. The film opens with a beggar being imprisoned after making some inappropriate comments at a nobleman's wedding. He is forgotten by all apart from the jailer and his mute daughter. After a disagreement between the jailer's daughter and the nobleman, she is thrown in prison with the beggar. The beggar sees this and takes advantage of the opportunity and rapes the jailer's daughter and dies. The daughter escapes prison, ends up in the woods, and is found by Don Alfredo. Months later, the daughter gives birth to a baby boy and dies soon after childbirth. However, this child was born on Christmas Day, which curses the boy, and he must try to control the curse. I love a good werewolf movie as it can show the struggle the person has to go through to try and control the animal within. However, this is unfortunately an example of a bad werewolf movie. Most of the film is a whole lot of nothing which struggled to keep my interest. The introduction to the film is especially hard to sit through as you start with the beggar, so you have to try and attach yourself to him. Then the jailer's daughter comes in, then Don Alfredo, and finally the boy Leon. Once you start to attach yourself to someone, they're gone. And all of this could have been avoided by maybe using a quick flashback towards the middle of the film. I can see why they cast Oliver Reed as Leon, as he's a big guy and they probably pictured him more as the werewolf than Leon. Leon is just a dull character who I feel just doesn't really go anywhere and I can't invest in him. We see him in his werewolf form for about 5 or 10 minutes towards the end, which isn't a good thing because if you're trying to tell a werewolf story, we need to see it more. Overall, I was very disappointed with the film and I wouldn't really recommend it to anyone. I feel this spends too long setting the stage and not enough time on the execution. This film needed a silver bullet through it early on in its 90-minute timescale.